The Bible is saying my people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. The Bible is saying that blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, we are the reason why we are destroyed. And when I say that, I mean because we refuse to accept this Bible, because we refuse to accept our true black culture and true black history found in this book, we are destroyed. A so-called white man can be a child molester. And guess what? He could be a rapist. And guess what? He goes scot-free. Harvey Weinstein right now is probably going to get off of charges of rape. Meanwhile, they stained Kobe Bryant's legacy with one rape case that he was found innocent of. But a white man could be a rapist and a molester, and it's okay. You know why? Because that's not our culture, black man. It's not our culture to be sexual deviants. It's not our culture to be murderers, man. The white man makes movies about how he's a gun-toting vigilante, how he kills and kills and kills. John Wick, The Terminator. The white man makes movies about him being murderers, and it's glorified. The black man is a murderer, and now these thugs and these criminals need to be put underneath the jail. Guess what? You know why? Because it's not black culture to be murderers, man. Our culture is found in this Bible. Guess what we never knew? Our culture is far more superior to any other culture on the face of the earth. But we want to run from it. We want to run from this knowledge, from this wisdom. And it's destroying our people, and the Bible is saying so. Read it again from the top.
Hosea chapter 4, verse 6. My people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge.
The Bible saying we are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. We get cancer because we smoke cigarettes when the box says this causes cancer. Not only that, the Bible tells us not to smoke. We are destroyed because we choose to be homosexuals and lesbians when God says we shouldn't be gay, man. We are destroyed when we follow after America and think that we can be stick-up kids and with the gunplay and then shoot up neighborhoods. We are destroyed when the Bible tells us to do something different. The Bible tells us that we are a holy people. Keep reading.
Because thou hast rejected knowledge, I will also reject thee.
The Bible says, blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, because we reject this knowledge found in the Bible, God is going to reject us. And it's not hard to believe. Look at our conditions wherever we are. Look at our conditions. Black people have the highest rate of AIDS, of high blood pressure, of diabetes, of cancer, of black-on-black crime, of abortions. We are the highest in everything negative, and that's not by chance. That's not because we just messed up in the head. What they like to say, black people have a condition, a genetic condition. You know, white people for so long taught that we were genetically inferior, when that's not the case. The problem is, we've been following after everybody else's culture except our own culture. And because of that, God is rejecting us. Our Heavenly Father is rejecting us because we have turned our back on His rules, man. Our families are destroyed because we turned our back on these laws, statutes, and commandments. This knowledge, man. We have been mentally destroyed by white America, man. We have been spiritually destroyed by America, man. That's why to this day, we have to go to a job interview and we have to change our voice. We got to put on clothes that we wouldn't normally wear. You know why? Because we are not allowed to be who we are. But guess what? There's hope, man. You come back here, you learn how to be a black man according to the Bible. We was never taught. This Bible is black history. The Christian church has lied to us all our lives. Give me Matthew 5 and 17. The Christian church tells us that, guess what? The laws are done away with. Christ came so that old covenant, you ain't got to follow that. Now you can eat shrimp and pork and crab and lobster. I'll help you. If the laws was done away with, why is the pastor still asking you to pay tithes? You know that's in the law. To pay 10% of your income, which is called tithes, that's in the laws. But according to the pastors, the laws is done away with. Can't we see by now that church has been running a game on our people for 400 years? Can't we see the Christian church is the reason why so many of our people have been molested and raped? The church is the reason why our grandmothers are broke because they're giving all their money to the pastor. The church is the reason why our marriages fail because your woman want to cook a plate for pastor and she can't even cook a plate for you. She got more reverence than for this pimp in this church than she does the old husband in her house. The church is the reason why the black community is destroyed, man. The church, because we have been taught in the Christian church to go against God, to go against Christ. When Christ said out of his own mouth that he came to make sure that we follow the laws in the Bible. The Bible is the black man's constitution. The Bible is our constitution. According to the white man's constitution, blacks are 3/5 of a human still. But guess what? There's hope. According to this book, we are the best people on the face of the earth. The Bible says blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans are the salt of the earth, man. Meaning what? We give the earth flavor. If America didn't have blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, this place would be just not fun at all. This place wouldn't be what it is without our people. Black people fill up the football arenas. Black people fill up the stadiums. Black people fill up the science arenas. They make us think that we only singers and entertainers. Guess what? We scientists. We're engineers. We're the brains behind every great invention that America benefits from. But we never get credit for it. We never get credit for it. You know why? Because if we knew our rich history according to this Bible, maybe we would start having pride in who we are. Maybe we wouldn't smoke a cigarette, which is known to give you cancer. Maybe our women wouldn't kill their babies in abortion clinics. Maybe black men wouldn't kill fellow black men. Tell them where you at.
The book of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 17. Think not that I come to destroy the law.
This is what Christ is saying. What color is these words?
Red.
In the Bible, whenever the words are red, that means Christ is speaking. And Christ, out of his own mouth, is saying, think not that I am come to destroy the law. This is cutting Christians off the top, because Christians will tell you that because of Christ, thank you, sister, that because of Christ, we don't have to follow the laws anymore. Well, Christ is saying something completely different. Read it again.
Think not that I come to destroy the law.
Christ is saying, don't think that I came to get rid of this law. You gotta understand something. Christ is a black man. He always was. This image right here is a lie. Christ is a black man, and you know what Christ advocated for? Christ wanted black people to follow the laws according to this book. You know why? Because Christ knew as long as we follow our laws in the Bible, white men couldn't rule over us. You know that, right? You know the only reason why white people rule over us is because we have left our knowledge and our wisdom in this Bible. It was never intended for us to be servants and slaves underneath these people. But the Lord said, if you go against this right here, you'll be in servitude. You will serve at people that are less than you. And look at us now. We work jobs for people that we know we're smarter than them. We work harder than them. We're stronger than them, but we're on the bottom. And that's because we didn't follow what Christ told us. Christ said, think not that I come to destroy the law. Keep reading.
Or the prophets.
Or the prophets. Let me let you in on something, Christians. Not only did Christ advocate that blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans follow the Bible, but all the prophets advocated the same thing. Every single prophet of God in this Bible, from Moses to Elijah to Jeremiah, all the prophets advocated and made and wanted our people to follow the laws of the Bible. Because when we follow this book, there's no black on black crime. There's no rape and molestation in our community. There's no sorrow and pain and hunger. There's no us living with rats and roaches, man. We're not on the bottom if we were to follow this Bible. And that's why Christ and all the prophets pleaded with our people that we follow this book. And we turned our backs. We turned our backs following the Christian church. The Christian church is the house of Satan, man. The Christian church inspires our people to do everything that's against God. You know, we just read it. Christ said, think not that I come to destroy the law or the prophets. But the Christian church tells you the law is done away with. Keep reading.
I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill.
Christ is saying, I'm not coming to destroy the law, but to what?
Fulfill.
Fulfill. What does the word fulfill mean? Let me help you. If anybody ever ordered something offline, like you ever ordered a package off of Walmart or Amazon offline, whenever your order is finished, it says order fulfilled. Meaning everything that you ordered and requested, they give it to you. Everything. And this is what Christ did. Everything that the Most High requested, Christ fulfilled. He gave it. He did it, man. Christ said he didn't come to destroy the law, but to do the law, Matt. And guess what? Christ followed this book, and he taught us that we should follow this book as well. Because us following this book is the answer to our people coming out of oppression wherever we are. Wherever we are, we should be ruling it. You know why? Because the Lord has ordained for us to be in charge. The Lord has ordained for us to be in leadership. The brother just brought out, the scripture says, when the wicked are in authority, the people mourn. Right now, wherever we are in mourning. Because the people that are in charge, the people that run the earth, the people that are over us are wicked people. And because of that, we are destroyed. Keep reading.
For verily I say unto you, till heaven and earth pass.
Christ is saying, for verily I say unto you. Verily is just old English for surely, truly. For truly I say unto you, till heaven and earth pass. Now let me ask you something. Are we still standing on the earth right now? Is the earth still here? Obviously. Is the heaven still here? Can we look up in the sky and see the clouds? So the earth and the heaven is still here. And Christ is saying, till heaven and earth pass,
one jot or one tittle.
In the Bible, when it says one jot or one tittle, a jot is the dotting of an I. A tittle is the crossing of the T, meaning every little detail. Keep reading.
Shall is no wise pass from the law.
Christ is saying that no little thing, everything should be fulfilled. No small thing should pass from the law. And this is why the Christian church is so wicked. Because the Christian church picks and chooses what laws they want to follow. They pick and choose which laws they want to enforce. They'll tell you, you got to pay your tithes. You know, churches got ATMs in the churches now. Churches, they got Cash App, hashtag Ebenezer Baptist Church, hashtag First Pilgrimage Missionary, Mount Zion, Olive on a Mount, Holy Jesus Christ in the Spirit Church. All the churches got Cash Apps and ATMs, so make sure that you pay that pastor his percentage. You know why? Because he's nothing more than a pimp. Whenever a hoe go out and she get a job and she make her money, what does the pimp do? He take his cut. He take his cut, and that's what the pastor does in them churches. Every time the people come in, he takes his cut. So that's why he enforces that law, but he doesn't enforce the law of the Bible that says you shouldn't steal. You shouldn't lie. You shouldn't be a child molester or a murderer or a rapist. The pastors ain't following that. But they want to enforce the laws that benefit them. Keep reading.
But to destroy, but to fulfill. Till all be fulfilled.